Welcome to Anjali's Bake Affair. Today I'm going to make something that will help you beat the heat and at the same time get the goodness of fruits. I'm going to be making sorbet. We'll be making two sorbets, but first let's understand what a sorbet is. A sorbet is many things. First, it's a frozen dessert. Second, it is fruit based. Third, it usually never has any milk, any cream. Number four, it's, I would say, by far the healthiest kind of frozen fruit dessert that you can eat. So let me tell you what goes into a sorbet. It's really quick, really easy, and so good to eat. We'll be making two kind of sorbets today. One is strawberry sorbet and the other is pineapple sorbet. To make a sorbet, there are many ways. Generally, we would combine fresh fruit with a simple sugar syrup. And if you don't want sugar, you can use honey, even maple syrup or condensed milk. A little bit of it, mix it, churn it and then freeze it. The other way, the one that I use, you know I always use the easiest way to make things. Yes, so the one that I use will give you instant sorbet. You'll make it and eat it immediately, or you can also freeze it for weeks inside the freezer. So what I do is, I use frozen fruit for it. We'll be starting with the pineapple sorbet. These are frozen pineapple circles that have also been sitting out of the freezer for about 10 minutes. They're soft. I'm going to chop them up into small pieces. So now I have all of this in chunks. I'm going to drop it into this processor. Now all we need to do is let this processor do its magic. We'll just pulse it first. Now if at any point you feel that it's not really churning anymore, that's because of course it's frozen, it's cold. Just take a spoon and give it a little mix, move it around and then back on with this. Yes, it's an exercise and a little bit of patience, that's it. Now we'll put the second ingredient, which is a bit of condensed milk, into this and begin churning it again. I want you to see, wow, see this yummy sorbet, and you know what, it's ready to eat. No freezing needed because our fruit was already frozen. I think I'll go in with a little bit of lemon juice. See, that's the thing about this, you can adjust the quantities according to your taste. And one more blitz and it's ready. I have these strawberries that I had frozen when they were in season. This particular batch of strawberries I specifically froze for the purpose of making sorbets during the summer. So you can see that I chopped them up and then I froze them and then I stored them into this pouch. Same thing I did with the pineapple. So what we will be doing is, we will be churning this frozen strawberry pieces with a little bit of condensed milk in a food processor, and our sorbet will be ready immediately to eat or to store. If you've seen my video, the one that I did on how to preserve your strawberries by freezing, it's there on my YouTube channel. I've shown you the exact process of how to preserve these strawberries by freezing them. You take them out, leave them out for about 10 minutes. So my strawberries have been out for about 10 minutes and they have thawed down slightly, which will make it easier for them to be churned in the processor. So what we are going to do is, we'll take a processor. This is about... two cups of strawberries, which I'm going to put in this. We'll just turn it about a little bit. And blitz it again. So now, look at that. How smooth, creamy and beautiful our sorbet has turned out. And you know what? Again, as I said, the best part is it's ready to eat. You can just... You can just dig into it right away. So now, let's get it out and plate it up. I'm going to use this ice cream scooper to get some lovely scoops of it. You can refreeze this. You can easily just put it back into your freezer. Look at this lovely, lovely thing.